Hello my dear friends, welcome back again in the new video of Power Learning channel. So today, just now I landed in a beautiful country, and here you see Qatar Airline is parked beside us, and now I am still in the plane, just landed, and we are waiting to go out from the plane. So my dear friend, in this video I will show you our new project where we synchronize the generator. So now this is our boat which will take us to our island, and really I enjoy this trip and this project. Now you know we are in the boat, and now boat is heading towards the resort. It's a beautiful resort where we will reach, and I will show you some of the clips during our video. So now this is the beautiful resort. We reach now to our resort. Now you see here still under construction, but the water here is very clean, very beautiful, and all the things I love, I enjoy it. This is the dream project for me, and I like it very much and enjoy my time here. So here you see my dear friends, this is our switchgear room where we have our synchronizing panel. In this project we use DeepSea 8610 controller for synchronizing with Schneider Electric motorized breaker and Lovato accessories like meter, relays, breaker, fuses from Lovato company. So here you see this is 1500 rpm generator now operating on load with DeepSea 8610 controller, and here you see these are the indication lamp, and here below we have our master packed Schneider breaker. Because Schneider breaker is very good and very reliable in synchronization operation, so we always recommend to use Schneider breaker, which is very reliable and very good in protection. So here you see this is our complete panel. Beside our synchronization panel, here we have one spare for generator number 5. In future, once we install the small generator in future, so this will be used. So now here you see we have our distribution board. All the load cables of this resort is connected here in this panel, okay, so operator can easily operate. So now you see here we have our 4 generators. Each generator is 625 kVA Aveco engine, and as you see now here we are very near to our engine, and these engines are very reliable, very good in operation. They are very heavy duty, that's why they are selected for this application.
We have 9500 liters of diesel tank. These diesel tank will be filled by diesel, and here you see these are the supply line of the engine which is going directly to the power plant room, and also the return line is coming from the same. As you see from the top side, we connect all the return line which is coming returning back the diesel. Here we have our sound louvers. The exhaust air, the radiator hot air passed from this, and now you see here we are inside our control panel. Here we have 4 pole breaker for generator protection and 4 pole for bus supply. Here we have positive breaker also, and also control cables for the circuit, all terminated here. This is very compact and we use very less here relays and other control to be simplified the application for operator, that easily they can work on this. Some of the suppliers I see, they install a lot of relays and breakers, so it will get confused the customer. So here is our multimeter where we see our voltages, and here is the master controller which is DeepSea 8610. Here you see on 40 41 42 43 we control the breaker from this. V1 is sensing supply of generator and V2 is bus supply. After that, from 52 to 58 this is our CT connection, and 59 to 70 this is our digital input. And here you see the DC supply for this controller is 8 volt to 35 volt. You can operate this controller from 8 volt to 35 volt. Here in the below section we have battery supply, emergency stop, fuel relay, okay, also digital outputs, analog inputs, and we have our ECU supply here, So this is all the connection. If you want to learn more about this, you can visit my more videos, which is in detailed for Deepsea 8610. So now you see, now we are in the plant room, and here above, if you see, we have our control panel. So this is our all setup here. So in the end of the video, I will show you something very important. So keep watching this video till the end, so you will give me answer for this question, which I will show you in my video. So let's get see what is our question. So here and now you see, I have clamp multimeter in my hand. So what I will do, let me show you what I am doing. As you see now, it's showing 0.6 ampere. Now here you see, I connect one wire on neutral, and now the other wire I will connect with our grounding bus bar. Okay, so I am testing voltage between neutral and ground. So it is showing us zero voltage because there is no connection between neutral and ground. But here if you see, this is very interesting thing. Now you see the amperage reading of earthing cable of the generator is 6.5 ampere. As you see, the clamp meter location is 6.5 ampere. But now once I put it on the bus bar, which is coming from the earthing pit, it already decreased. So you can comment me about this reason why the earthing ampere is suddenly decreased in the comment box below, and inshallah I will see you in the next video. Till that, take care and have a nice day. Assalamu alaikum.